21 conversation. In this series, we'll be talking to 21 different people from Sydney InfoTech who will talk about business, leadership, the world of information technology, and about their own experiences and many more things. So here we go.
Hello. In the second episode of 21 Conversation, we'll be speaking to the business head of Signature, Mr. Logesh Lakhande, and we'll be talking to him about the world of digitization, how e-signing boomed during COVID, where he's also known as the most calm personality of Signature for him. Let's find out more.
Hi, good morning. Today we have with us Logesh, our head of Signature. So Logesh, the very first question that I have is, what is the basic difference between a real one-on-one conversation versus the virtual conversations that we are having today?
Today I am in office, you are in office, so we are able to chat, right, face to face. But in the virtual world, I'm sure we all know that there is a computer and all the people are inside the computer, right? So that's the difference in one word. Now everybody is interacting with other people through this small window of your laptop or your phone. And that face-to-face kind of connect is missing. However, I'm sure there are many advantages to this. You can get your work done from anytime, anywhere, and also be more effective, more productive in one way.
How this entire pandemic has brought in place the need for e-signing, has it made things easier for businesses?
Definitely, the world has changed. I mean, people are talking about the new normal now. And while the old world is getting transformed, the new normal has already started being accepted by most people.
Most businesses.
Absolutely. People are transforming, businesses are transforming, and companies are now allowing their employees to decide whether to work from home, whether to work from office.
How has the technology matured? How is the flow working today?
If you look at large organizations, maybe in the pharma industry and all, which are very regulated, and they have to really track who is doing the process, who is signing the documents, who is approving the test results, etc. All those things not possible to do now because everybody is at home. So there has to be some enabler, some tool to do this even while working from home. So this is where I think the solution of electronic signature and online signing has been a very effective way to get things done. The pandemic has really given a boost to this, and people are noticing the advantages of using electronic signatures.
And so in this entire process, the main question arises is of security, the encryption of data, basically how safe the document can be and how does one authenticate the document?
Yeah, that's a very good question, and most organizations are concerned about that. Because when you are signing paper documents, they are in your office, they are in your drawers. However, when it is electronic signing and these solutions are cloud-based solutions, then obviously you are uploading your document online somewhere. So companies are concerned, and rightly so, as to where their documents are being stored, where they are moving, how they are moving, etc. Answer to your first question is that most of these electronic signature solutions are online, which means you can access them over a browser and you can upload your document, set the entire signing workflow there, which means like who is going to be the first person who will sign, second, third, and so on. And then the solution itself manages the entire workflow in the back end. It's very important to authenticate that person or find some way to register his identity. So in different countries, there are different ways. For example, in India, we have something known as Aadhaar e-sign, or a digital signature issued by the government authority known as a certifying body. And using that digital signature, you will be able to then authenticate that person. So you will basically know who he is, maybe what's his Aadhaar number, PAN card number.
How would you like to conclude this entire and sum up the entire process of e-signing or the concept of e-signing? Do you think it has evolved? Is it mature? What is your thought?
I personally feel and I believe that e-signatures are maybe even more secure and reliable than the even handwritten signatures. Just look at it. If I just sign some paper, how will you even know that I have signed it or somebody else has signed it?
Yes.
But if I sign a document electronically, there will be a way to prove that it is actually me who signed it. So in that case, organizations should actually trust electronic signatures much more than even the handwritten signatures.